And welcome to the Rebel Love Show. We are a once-a-week broadcast from Manchester, New Hampshire, where we are pro-pot, pro-gun, and pro-coffee. Find all of our contents at rebelloveshow.com. I am Ron Mathias.
And I am the Rebel Mistress.
And we got a bunch to talk about. We haven't been on 2 weeks now because we always take off the first week of the month for the new movers party. We got to talk about the primaries, unfortunately. Hopefully, we won the last federal elections ever held in the Shire, if we have anything to say about it. So much has happened in the last couple of weeks. Biggest news, I know it's been talked about.
What day was it exactly that the move was triggered?
The move was triggered a week ago today.
A week ago today.
Yeah, so a week ago today, during the day of a new movers party.
It was the second, so it was in February.
Okay. Yeah. Free State Project, I know it's been talked about forever, already for a week now, but the Free State Project finally triggered the move. They got 20,000 people signed up to saying, hey, we're going to move to New Hampshire for the Free State Project. Both myself and the Rebel Mistress here are signers and early movers
for the Free State Project. I expected a bigger party for the move being triggered.
Well, it happened during a... It did happen during the new movers party, the last early new movers party, mind you. Every new movers party afterwards is just a normal new mover.
Wait. Everyone, it's just a normal move. Okay, yeah, that's
That was the first early, that was the last early new movers, because we're early new movers. We moved before the move was triggered.
Yeah, so they're just new movers.
Yeah, they're just new movers.
Well, before we get into all of that, I guess that happened on the week. So how was your weekend after that? The move was triggered. We went to the new movers party, which was awesome.
After that, that was a crazy week that week.
Yeah, it was.
What did I do? I saw DJ Down on Thursday. I believe it was Thursday. You were doing Flaming Freedom that day.
Yeah, yeah. Shout out to DJ Aurelius and Flaming Freedom every Thursday night at 10 p.m.
Hit it up. So that happened. Cody did another spiritual journey down here or whatnot. I don't know. He was here. I remember seeing him. I see him every weekend at this point.
Send Cody O'Connor some Bitcoin. Make his life a little bit easier. Yeah. And then send us some Bitcoin, too.
Yeah, you can donate to us. We never actually ask for donations, but we do take donations. If you're just go to Rebel Love Show, you'll see the QR code over there. What else? Oh, your bridal shower.
Yay, my bridal shower.
Your bridal shower is there.
Yeah, my bridal shower happened this weekend. My first one.
Hopefully. Yeah. Well, it could be more than one. Who knows in the future?
Yeah, who knows? But hopefully, I doubt it. I never want to plan anything ever again.
Yeah, it's been taking a lot.
I did a great job planning, though. Like, I have to give myself a pat on the back. Like, I had sunflower tablecloths.
It should have been someone else planned it, but that's okay.
Someone else should have planned it, but they didn't. But let me just give you some highs and lows. Okay, high point. Dear friend of mine, a mentor, someone who's like a mother to me, she came up from Georgia, and we went to go pick her up on Friday with Renee Late, and we drove through the snow, and Renee Late's door, it wouldn't close. We came to like see Rob at work, and then her door wouldn't close because she's not sane, and so we had to take his car and drive it through Boston in the snow. And Renee drives like an asshole already. And she like forgets her glasses. Like, it was just a long day.
I couldn't believe you trusted her to drive you down to Boston while it's snowing. I mean,
without glasses. No, Renee's, I didn't.
Renee's
went back home.
Infamous for, being a horrible driver, especially in the snow.
No, she just drives really fast. But we went to go get her.
She drives like she's from Mass, which means she's a horrible driver.
Well, to her, it means she's a great driver. But anyway, so we drove to Mass and we picked up my mentor and we came back up here, which was really nice. I hadn't seen her in like two and a half years. And, you know, I was wondering, I had been telling her about the Free State Project, what my life's like now, what I do. So she finally got to see that in action. And she said she left with a new state of mind, that she has a different perspective on some things. And I like that. I thought that was very interesting. But the bridal shower...
No, go ahead.
The bridal shower was really fun. I had a dress code because
some people seem to go with, and some people did not.
Yeah,
I mean, there's some things you gotta look classy for. I mean, if you're going to a bridal shower, if you're part of the bridal party, you would dress appropriately for it.
Yes, like, exactly.
You would assume that.
Style, you know? And class all the way here, people.
Yeah.
Like sunflower tablecloths, like with lace. This was the real.
You're all about the sunflowers.
Deal. I was. I had sunflower cupcakes. I had a make your own mimosa bar, a photo wall that printed Polaroids. Like,
which I found that camera for.
It was an awesome bridal shower. And Renee was a low because she wore a tank top, a blue tank top and jeans to my bridal shower.
Yeah, I was a little shocked by that.
It was the saddest point of the bridal shower. But yeah, that's what happened. And this wedding is getting closer and closer. We're actually going to film our wedding invitation.
I know we practiced the other day.
Yes, we did. It went really well.
Kids, we are making our own, how full of ourselves we are. we're making our own wedding invitation, and you'll see it when it comes out.
It's going to
be amazing.
We're going to do that soon, and our wedding should be listed in Porkfest, but it's going to be at Porkfest, and everyone is invited, unless you're definitely not invited.
Yeah, there's a couple of people that aren't, but you know who you are.
Yeah, everyone's invited, just some people aren't. That's how I'm just going to phrase it. Anyway, so that was a very, very, very hectic weekend for us, but still a lot of fun.
Well, it was a pleasure meeting your mentor there. I can't wait to see her at Porkfest.
I hope she,
hopefully she's going to be able to handle like Porkfest. Like, I mean, I'm not going to hold back. I'm not going to be holding back in front of her. So,
you're not going to be holding back? What does that even mean? What is Rob Mathias in full
swing? We smoked
pot
and that was it. And like, it was a chill environment. Like, Porkfest is a different story, and everything's gonna be moving very crazily, especially if she's there like Thursday night. Obviously, she'll be there Thursday night for us, but like be there Friday night. So Friday night's like the party night.
Everyone likes to party.
But that was pretty much an entire party.
The whole
pretty
week.
Much, yeah, basically Tuesday on. Pretty much since the moment I proposed to you last Porkfest, it was a party nonstop the whole time.
Well, and before the wedding, we have our bachelorette party, which we'll be on the show ranting about. Well, hopefully, it'll be awesome.
Well,
hopefully.
I'm sure we'll talk about it on the show, but it's not gonna be part of the show. That'd be kind of weird.
Why? Anyway, so that was pretty much my weekend planning for that. I did a lot of planning. Amazon is a lifesaver. I didn't do it through Free Talk Live, though I thought about it.
We should set that up for us.
I use Amazon all the time.
I'm just too lazy. Like, there is I won't say what festival it is, but there is a festival out there that wanted us to come out. And was like, the organizer's like, why don't you, do like a GoFundMe campaign or ask for donations in Bitcoin or something like that. I hate asking for money. Like, I have to sell sell something for money to go do something.
How would you sell yourself? If the audience right now had to invest in you to get to this anarchist trip, like, well, how would you sell yourself? Give me a pitch.
I don't even want to go into the pitch because I don't even want
to
do that.
But
why
if
would
you
I?
Had to, could you? You're
could.
The master salesman.
Yeah, yeah,
like,
I could.
It's like the version of sell me this pen. Like, sell me yourself. Why should people give
because
you Bitcoin?
Because I wouldn't buy it. I even when I sell to other people, I wouldn't buy that either. But
asking people for money, but people should give me money if they want.
If you guys want to give us money, feel free.
To go to a festival and help them party. They want us to MC their party. That's what they want.
I'm sure they do.
No, that's literally what they want. So, I mean, DJ is crowd fun. I don't know.
That's just too much work. I don't want to put in work to beg for money.
You don't
crowd, like, that's not my
you
thing.
You don't crowd fun for, like, your rent. Like, I don't like people who do it like, oh, I can't pay my rent. Oh, I need to, like, go to the mall and buy this purse or something. Like, that's a different story. Like, going to a conference or a convention or something.
It's the same thing. It's filling our desire to go there.
Look, babe, let the market speak. If people want
to if someone wants to pay for airfare and stuff like that for us, feel free. But I don't think that's going to happen. And I'm not going to push the beg for it. It's not my thing.
Donations, begging, who cares? If you want to donate, donate. When we come back, we're going to take an easy shot and we're going to talk about politics and shit. Yo, yo, yo. Vermin Supreme, 2016.
I did not hear the break coming in at all.
These headphones are great. This mic is actually really loud. Like, that's why I'm not even talking close to it. That's better.
Okay, I'm just turning that down a little bit. Well, you can control yours manually.
State Project has reached its goal of 20,000 liberty lovers who've pledged to move to New Hampshire and get active to achieve liberty in our lifetime. Perhaps you're trying to figure out what part of New Hampshire should be your destination. If so, consider Keene. You'll find more than 150 reasons to move to Keene at move.freekeene.com. Keene is famous for
a Rebel Trump show.
I don't get it.
Rebel Trump show. Rebel Trump show. Activism, news, and opinion. For years, we've been compiling over
150 reasons to move.
I forgot he was here.
You never took the dog back?
He licked my foot and I forgot
he
was
here. Oh my god.
I was like, well, what the fuck just licked my foot? No, you're scrolling. I'm like,
after the death of leader Kim Jong-il, North Korea's 24.5 million citizens have returned to their regular daily routines this week, holding a festive synchronized disco jump rope gala in Pyongyang's main public square. Life in the hermetic communist nation is reportedly beginning to normalize following the protracted mourning period, with citizens once again donning their brightly colored uniforms and performing intricate gymnastics routines in perfect unison.
It is an inspiring sight to see so many loyal citizens find the strength to unfurl their long silken streamers and do dozens of tandem backflips set to dance music.
Observers reported that new North Korean leader Kim Jong-un nodded once in approval of the disco jump rope gala, signaling an official transfer of power.
A recent study from the Centers for Disease Control finds that over 100 million children are being exposed to harmful levels of stupidity in their own homes. Hear the debate about secondhand ignorance on the next In the Know.
This is the Onion News Network.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photos.
You're bringing it back, baby, now.
Okay.
Still want to talk about FSP hitting 20K.
What else did you... Oh, you want to talk about the press conference?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll come back on that then.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.lrn.fm. Get all your shopping done.
And after that, you can change the subject when you feel the need.
I mean, I feel like...
We need to talk about a segment, so we didn't talk about the press conference.
I wasn't disagreeing with you.
Yeah.
I was just gonna say, I feel like it all fades in.
Ah, my beard is so fucking itchy.
To find the medicine he needs, he discovers a community of survivors.
You know, struggle is real, babe. You don't know what it's like.
Has he finally found the safe haven he's been looking for, or will he discover that school bites?
What?
Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, and read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And don't forget, you can Skype us here live. Come join the show. Our Skype name is Rebel Love Show. We will take your calls. So we were talking about what happened this weekend. And after the bridal shower, we were a bit hungover. I know I was. At least, like, just exhausted. But we decided in the morning we were going to go. No, that was before that. I don't even remember. Yes, that was before the bridal shower when we went to the press conference.
Oh, that was like days before the bridal shower.
Okay. Yeah, all right, merging in together with me. That's how tired I am.
Yeah, so right.
But anyway, so we decided to get up early and go to this press conference, which I'm glad because Rob was like, oh, maybe we can just sleep in. And I'm like, no.
I don't know about you, but for me, I've been wanting the movie to be triggered for years. Should have already happened at any rate.
You think it should have already... I thought it was, like, predicted for, like... What year did they originally think the move would be triggered? back when you were waiting for it for so long?
I had no idea. I think they did predict it around this time. How long did you expect to wait then? How long did I expect to wait?
Yeah.
I expected it to happen a year ago.
A year ago?
Yeah.
I joined but a year ago.
I don't know. I thought it'd happen a year ago.
I was off by a year. What I found most interesting about the press conference is when Jason Sorens.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, when he spoke and he was saying about from like a marketing standpoint and everything, when they started the Free State Project and they took the votes to see whether it was going to be New Hampshire or what even is that other place?
Say that again?
New Hampshire. They were voting between New Hampshire.
So basically when the Free State Project first started, there was when they hit 5,000 signers, that's when they had a vote on what states to pick for the Free State Project. So Alaska is one of the heavy hitters. So was Wyoming.
But it wasn't. It was just between Wyoming and New Hampshire, right?
Yeah.
And he said he held a press conference too early, and he blew his load too quickly, and they announced that it was going to be in New Hampshire. And then after that, he didn't really think it was going to happen because people, like, there wasn't as much press getting it out there. But then he said it kind of developed on its own from there. People started researching, and they found the Free State Project, and that's something they wanted to be a part of. And I really thought that was really interesting because people are actually seeking
I was definitely one of those people.
So
I'm definitely cool. In that camp. I had to find this out. Like I was looking for something like this for years. And then I was introduced to it. I think via like a podcast or something like that way down the road. Or a video of someone going to Pork Fest. But I had to seek it out going through. This wasn't just introduced to me. Like I had to like find it going through my own research of like what's going on in the world. What can we do?
Yeah.
Blah, blah, blah.
But yeah, I found that really interesting because, you know, no matter how you like find it or whatever, it's just that the fact that people want it and that it was such a great number of people that even after they had lost all their press attention, they still were able to trigger the move. Like, and I feel like 2016, like that's not bad. Like, something, 20,000 people to agree on one thing, like, that's pretty good.
Well, I definitely agree. Now, I don't see those original 20,000 moving. Who knows? Maybe we'll get a
but you can still be a signer, so.
Yeah.
Maybe people will see that move and be signers, so.
Well, I mean, I guess I'm fine with it.
You're fine with it? You're such a pussy.
Okay, no, I'm not. I'm not fine with it. It's... Look, that number meant that counter, that ticker, that meant a lot of people that signed, you know?
AKA you.
Yeah, because, like, it's, I know it shouldn't bother me. It shouldn't mean anything to me, but, like, being a signer means something. And if anyone can still be a signer, even after the move is triggered, I don't know. It just bothers me a little bit. Like, I'm not saying don't move. I'm just like, I don't know if, like, I already signed and moved. You know, and someone can just sign ahead. They can still sign, and it's just a mental thing.
I feel like, your mental thing is no one else's, like
I'm not,
that's crazy.
Like, I'm not hardcore, which, I mean, I guess I'm kind of hardcore in the fact that I want to see FSP disband at some point, so other people focus on doing things here instead of just getting people to move.
What would you like to see
done?
Which
is a fine thing to do. Well, right... I'm fine with the FSP staying intact for the time being to, you know, to show all the people moving. So I kind of get that. That's their, like, now that's what their goal really is. And they're doing kind of a good job with some of them really putting a focus on the different Facebook groups that are there to help.
Yeah, I feel
movers.
Like Facebook so has definitely increased.
I'm definitely down for that, but I don't know about the signer part.
I don't care. Like, I have no care at all. It's not a... emotional thing for me. Like, if you want to be a sign, like, I don't even care.
I'm sure,
like,
it's an emotional thing for people who have been here 10
the
years.
The only thing is that I think is that there is no counter for when they're signers. So you can be a signer, but you're not a part of the original 20,000. You know that. We know that. The only time you get a number is when you actually move.
I would put out a compromise on that. What if you move in the next 5 years, regardless if you signed, I'll call you a free stater. That's my compromise.
See, I don't even care. Like, you should be. I feel like a free stater is anyone who, moves to New Hampshire or like signs to be a friend of the Free State.
No, that's a porcupine.
No, see, they that's just like here. Too many like labels and titles and bullshit. Like, that's how you start creating a system.
Well, I don't like using the word freestater anyways. I don't like using that in like the public and stuff like that. I don't call other people freestater. Oh, yeah, that's a freestater. That's a pork. Well, those are porks. People use the word pork. They don't use the word freestater.
I don't know why.
Like, I sometimes actually like, kind of, I feel like when I was a local gonna, says it, I actually at first think of it as, like, a negative. Like,
look, I was going to say, we named this show Politics and Shit, and we don't even have to switch topics because, it's like, everything you're saying is so political. Like, you're like, oh, you have to do this, be this, and if you don't do this in time, then you're not this. And it's just like, oh, so you're, like, implementing this system. Like, it should not matter. The only thing that should matter is when fuck people labels. Move, then, you know, there's a number. And I feel like the signer clock was, like, a lot of work for some people. It seemed like they were really stressed out. Like, you get it done. Now get people moved. Like, focus on that. Like, not financially, which was the other point I liked during the press conference. But, you know, resources. And I feel like there are so many. There's FSP housing, job alerts.
What?
But you just got to do it at the end of the day.
Yeah, that's one thing that some people have asked before. And I think I even asked this before I moved. It's like, is there any, like, financial, like, support mechanism in place by the Free State Project
what? That
help people?
You want the Free State Project to support you?
Yeah, like, you're in the wrong camp there, buddy. Like, you know, we're not going to pay you to come here.
No.
You know, that's not how it works. You know, just like how, like, I don't want to pay immigrants to come anywhere. Like, you got to get here in your own solution, like, your own way. You got to be able to handle yourself and pay for yourself.
Yeah.
You know, this is called life. If you don't want the government, you know, there's no one supporting you. So there can't be someone supporting you to get here.
No, yeah. I feel like a lot of times people are just scared of change. They're like, but New Hampshire, like, once you realize, like, there's limited taxes and housing is not that expensive. Like, it's very, like, relative to a lot of other places in the world. Like, there's a lot of stuff you can do. But we're going to get more into politics and the press conference when we come
Vermin
back.
Vermin Supreme.
2016, y'all.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim. You know, it's so crazy how locals know about Vermin Supreme. People love.
Yeah,
you know, my boss got a selfie with Vermin.
Did he post it in selfies with Vermin Supreme?
No, he posted it on Facebook.
You should tell people about this group so they'll ask.
I should. I should invite people to go there. What's the problem, officer? Okay, it's broadcasting. I'm trying to open it.
Did you press start broadcast?
Yeah, no, I did.
Did you?
But it's not like working on the web browser, and I don't really feel like.
Did you? Do you ever go to output? Go to output, and go to right here. Start off.
Why?
Just click it.
I don't need to.
Just click it.
Why? I don't want to ruin it. It's recording now.
It's,
I don't want to.
It's
do
not
that.
Gonna ruin it. I feel like that, like, is that, that may be why it's not on there. I always click start all, and then it always works.
That has nothing to do with the.
Fine. Well, I won't offer you anything. You know everything
already.
It says
live stream is starting soon. It should be starting.
What about, oh, never mind, you know everything. Never mind.
No, I have right here. I have this.
Maybe you need it to restart the computer.
No, I don't think that's it.
Why not? Right, why don't you think that's it?
Stopping.
Did you restart the computer when you started?
This happened last time. And when I reopened this and restarted the broadcast, it worked.
Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. so I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My magic mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin, mymagicmud.com.
Did you know you can listen to LRN.fm via our free-to-air satellite channels? We have channels over nearly all of North America and much of Africa. All you need is an affordable receiver and a dish as
well. It's your turn to bring it back.
Yeah, I know. But I am trying to get this going right now.
If you are a broadcaster or want to be one, this is a good delivery method for our content. See our coverage maps and get details at sat.lrn.fm. That's sat.lrn.fm. sat.lrn.fm.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this, right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it, and once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world, so I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And we've been talking a little bit about the FSP hitting the 20K mark, and we were a little dabbing in the primaries happening here in the Shire. And I'll be honest, I hope this is, you know, I want to make my life's work to make sure that the federal government no longer has primaries here in the Shire going forward. Like, I'm tired of, like, everywhere being just a, you know, littered with political signs left and right. All these out-of-staters coming in here and, you know,
you're
going everywhere.
Foreigners?
And, you know, having to stop for presidential motorcades left and right. Ugh. Ugh. I'm done with it. I can't stand the primaries. Like, I'm so glad it's over.
I think
so
it's very, like, coincidental that, like, the move was triggered just as, like, the whole Politico scene starts just getting crazy here.
You know, I was really hoping that would allow, I know they got a lot of press coverage. I know Vice picked it up, CNN picked it up, they had some video interviews, Washington Post talked about it. But I was really hoping that would make, like, a major more news, especially with it being by the primary than it did.
I feel like you're kind of greedy here. Like, Vice, CNN, Washington Post, there were some more articles out there too. I seen Carla featured in a lot of stuff. I feel like it got a lot of coverage.
No, it definitely did.
I feel like it'll get more coverage once people start moving. So, for instance, like, it happened, say, next New Movers Party, I want to see, like, 30 people. 40, 50. Like, I wanted to up. I want the New Movers Party to be so big that they finally change venues. Then when stuff like that starts happening, then it kind of makes a bigger splash. And also, like, I feel like people forget, like, yes, we're all fair weather activists, but it's also really cold outside. And there's been, like, a lot of press and stuff lately. But, I feel like with the more snow and stuff happening, the less, like, press coverage you're going to get. Like, in this region? I don't know. I feel like everyone's here now, but they're going to, like, clear out
tomorrow.
Oh, yeah,
all the press downtown Manchester's going to be gone tomorrow.
Well, if something influential happens, yeah, if something influential happens, like, tomorrow, like, they're going to be gone. But, yeah, I mean, I feel like everything's been happening so fast. It's all the politics with the FSP, wondering what's the next step and what's the next move. And then we got, like, the big dogs here, you know, the people who are gonna own you, who want to be your owners.
Yeah,
like, people are voting for them.
It's crazy. Like, there's this huge big announcement with so many people within the, you know, the Free State Project and the Liberty Movement and all that jazz, and then literally at the exact same time, the federal government's having their own little tiny, you know, tiny, but their election, their worshipness of like the system and stuff like that, while we're doing this at the exact same time.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely crazy when you think of it that way.
Rob, did you vote? I know you're a statist.
No, I did not. So. I am not a fucking statist. Well, you always say this shit and that is not true whatsoever. I am not a statist. I didn't even vote for Vermin Supreme, even though we did come out and endorse Vermin Supreme, saying if you are going to vote,
vote for Vermin Supreme.
You know, and he did beat a lot of candidates today.
Yeah.
Now here's the thing.
He came in fourth place.
Fourth, that's pretty high for him.
Yeah,
I wish he got higher. He should have got third or second, but you know,
yeah, he should have definitely got third.
You know what Vermin Supreme's missing?
Field of Vern. What? Yeah,
you know what? Field of Vern. You know what Vermin Supreme's campaign's missing?
A hot black chick. Vermin Supreme. A hot black chick.
You know, if the Rebel Mistress ran as his VP, you know, he'd go into double digits easily for sure. But he's missing the Snapchat game. Like, he should, let's let all the kids are on, you know, I'm sure, like, on Snapchat, like, I found out all who the won kids. The New Hampshire primary today, or who the predicted winner is, by looking at Snapchat.
Yeah, Snapchat.
And they have,
shit.
Like, all these filters for, like, Trump and Bernie and stuff like that.
Forget
and,
these pissant technology, like, YouTubers that'll say, like, Snapchat is, like, on the same level as something like WhatsApp. Oh, that's bullshit. God. Snapchat is, like, hitting up Facebook at this point. Like, I can literally go read Cosmo on Facebook.
Didn't Facebook come out with a Snapchat, like, equivalent?
No, I think Facebook bought Snapchat.
Did they buy Snapchat?
I think something like that was like is the case.
No, they had their own.
I feel like they bought it. I don't know. Chat, you Google it.
Yeah, Google that chat and let us know. Skype and tell us that we're wrong or right on Snapchat.
Because we don't know. But I feel like it's the equivalent. I feel like Snapchat may be even one-upping Facebook. Just like so many features, and they're adding new stuff like every day, every week. And then soon that'll be old because, you know, whatevs. But, you know, what surprised me was you can do your, like, local story. So ours is New Hampshire, so it has, like, people from all around us can add their story to this, like, giant story. And so today it was all the people voting. And I'm like, oh, my God, let me
I
see these
so
Trump supporters.
I felt so sick watching these people telling me how to vote and some civic duty and all that jazz.
Yeah,
it was
I'm
sickening.
I'm running to the polls. I'm running to the polls. Let me go vote. Yeah. Like,
I got to go tell my master. I gave them a suggestion box on who should be my master for the next 4 years. I got to do that today.
Good for you.
I mean, that's literally what these people are, like, you know, happy about.
I mean, it was just, I just wanted to see what kind of signs and stuff they had. A lot of the presidential candidates just out there shaking hands, like, whipping out their penises. I don't know, like, what they were doing. But I just wanted to see what kind of people were voting for each kind of person. And the Trump supporters didn't, like, I wanted to see, like, a difference, I guess, but I didn't see any difference. They all were the same kind of sheeple.
I will say this. I find, I find Trump supporters to be more negative compared to Bernie supporters, who are more positive. Now, don't get me wrong. Bernie supporters are just a bunch of fascists. I'm not saying that's not the case.
They're a bunch of youngins who want Bernie Sanders
to be
their grandpa.
Yeah.
Sit him on their lap. Oh,
oh
free college.
This,
you wanna,
this
you
old
wanna,
guy's promising us college.
Oh, my God. Free, like, ice cream,
free
burgers, free
healthcare.
Free kittens. Like, yeah, he's the granddad I never had before. That is what they're saying in Bernie. Like, because there are so many of my peers who are voting for Bernie Sanders. They're voting for him, and it's like, oh, he drives this, like, old hippie, like, election bus. Have you seen it? It's like this blue school bus.
Well, he's
like,
from
all
Vermont. He's Mr. Hippie. He's cool.
He's still dropping bombs, and he still believes.
No, he's still pro-war.
He's still pro-war.
He's been pro-war candidate.
I did want to read the George Carlin quote. I solve this political dilemma in a very direct way. I don't vote on election day. I stay home. I firmly believe that if you vote, you have no right to complain. Now, some people like to twist that around. They say, if you don't vote, you have no right to complain. But where's the logic in that? If you vote and you elect D, dishonest, incompetent politicians and they get into office and screw everything up, you are responsible for what they have done. And I feel like I believe in that. Like, I thought that if you vote for Vermin Supreme, you know, I wouldn't have judged you as much because I think Vermin Supreme is the president America deserves, like, next to Trump.
We need but zombie at, power.
At least Vermin Supreme has, like, a zombie apocalypse plan. Yeah. So at least he's responsible.
And he's for mandatory toothbrushings. I mean, who can't get behind that? I mean, let's kill gingivitis in here and now.
Jesus. I don't know. I feel like people who are voting for Vermin Supreme and people who are voting for Trump have a lot in common. Like, they secretly want, you know.
Well, the big difference between, well, I got jumped the gun there. The biggest difference between Trump and Vermin is that the people supporting Trump don't think that Trump is legit. Where, like, people that are supporting Vermin Supreme see him as the artist that he really is.
Yeah, but the people just secretly want a supreme leader, you know?
That's true. People, well, if you are voting, you are voting because you want a ruler, not just a leader.
Even a subconscious leader. You know, I have to be honest. Like, I did think a lot of the stuff that I was hearing about Trump was a joke. I thought they were joking about the wall and all this stuff. I thought it was a joke. What can I say? But I went to his website. And I'll tell you what I found when we came back. You can tell your election story when we come back. Because I was trying to,
I still am trying to get this fucking page to work. Like, I don't understand why the YouTube feed ain't working right.
It's the world's largest small interest libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people feel passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brookridge Daily Precious
Metals. Let's see if this is working now. There we go. We're up and running. $92 per
ounce. Silver is up 4 cents. Look at my hair. It looks so good. 9 cents per
ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $375. We're offering up to 200 Gold American Eagle 10th-ounce coins for $60 off the usual ounce price each. Call us and ask about this special at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats and the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them, comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like on facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it and click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but
it's my turn to bring it back, right?
Yep.
Okay, I'm gonna bring it back to your story.
Okay.
Never send a follow-up email asking, did you get my email? Email 101. If it didn't bounce back undeliverable, it got where you sent it. And avoid
transmedia-mastering,
like calling to ask, did you get my email?
Want to take that off?
Emailing to say, I left you a voicemail.
Where's the bottom of it?
Aren't being acknowledged. Your problem isn't technology, it's technique. Is your message precise and understandable? Have you boiled it down to seem as relevant as possible to the recipient? In other words, is it the opposite of spam or junk mail? This really matters if you're a job seeker. But even if you're not, with money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Now that you've found the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM, you may want to help expose others to our great programs. To assist you in doing so, you'll find resources at promote.lrn.fm, including details on how to get a free bumper sticker, quarter-page flyers you can print out and distribute, banners for your website, as well as files that will allow you to make your own custom banners and graphics. Visit promote.lrn.fm and help bring new listeners to the Liberty Radio Network. That's promote.lrn.fm.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org. You can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Are you going to do the hand thing? And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. We are talking about voting. So, I personally don't vote. I'm not registered to vote. I wonder if I have to register to vote to be a state representative.
I don't think you have to be registered to vote to run for an election. I'm 99.9% sure that is not the case.
And I'll run on the platform not voting. And if you vote for me, I'll be as conservative as possible.
I think you'd be as anarchist as possible if you won.
Yeah, as anarchist as possible, but conservative is like my PC term.
Your PC term? What does that even mean?
It's like when you run as a Republican, because that's the majority in your in your region.
Are you okay? Are you okay with politician? If you ran as a politician, you know you'd be an anarchist politician. Would you run openly as an anarchist, or would you say what you have to say in order to get elected? Just like you put an R or D next to your name just to get elected.
No, I'd run openly as an anarchist.
But would you
I'd
run on a party plan, like as a Republican or as a Democrat?
I'd probably run as a Republican.
A Republican anarchist.
Yeah.
Okay. Just making sure.
Yeah, that's what I do. But that's a long time from now. Anyway,
not really. That's going to fly by. That's going to happen really quickly.
We'll see. I think voting is almost violence.
You say it's almost violence. What's your big gripe with voting?
I feel like for me, it's almost violence because it's just really going against like everything I believe. Like, if I don't believe in the system, why am I even like buying into this game that they could make, like, that these people are valid in my mind, that they have some kind of grasp over me, which I don't believe that at all. So I feel like if you're like playing into that, then, you know, you still do it to some level. And as we've learned from the Hunger Games, you can't trade one tyrannical dictator for another, like, with prettier words, aka Bernie Sanders. Hi. Like, oh, no, he's no different. He's really the same. He's just saying, you know, nicer things. He's painting a hippie sign on it. He's riding in a blue bus. He's an old man promising free college and Vermin Supreme.
Free college,
free
ponies. Well, yeah, but if there were free ponies issued to everyone, that'd be a job creator, because there'd be so many people that would need to hire people to take care of those ponies. All right? We're talking like a huge economic driving force in this country, and ponies is what we need.
I take ponies before college. It's like people don't understand.
Who wouldn't take a pony before going to college? Who wants to go to school?
Exactly. And it's like people, if you ever did go to college, like, how do you understand how economics works? Because you can't just give people free shit. That's like just, oh, I'm going to just print money. You can't do that. Like, the more you print, the higher cost gets, and then inflation. And that's why your dollar is only worth like 25 cents right now, because our economy is already not that great. So we're going to give people free college to go along with our already shitty economy. Is he just trying to tank it completely? Like, and these are the people, like, these people get to make decisions about, like, what happens to my life and my ovaries and my uterus. Like, I find that a bit bizarre. So that's what my big beef with voting. I don't know what your beef with not voting is, or you like to vote since elementary school or something.
No, I don't know. I have no. Well, first off, I have not liked voting since elementary school or something.
I was a person who advocated
voting. I remember being one of those people rooting for your candidate, and like I remember rooting for Ron Paul. Like, oh, Ron, he's gonna win. He's gonna win. This is the year. Oh my God, he's running again. No, I used to be like that. But I do have a story from. When I was, I believe I was in the sixth grade. It was before high school.
I have some pictures of you from the sixth grade. Please, I'll share them in the chat.
Please do not ever share those photos in the chat. Oh, my God. I was a horrible-looking kid growing up.
I'm going to share them at our wedding reception.
Why would you do... No, you will not do that. People will take pictures of that. I don't want... That is my former life. Don't be posting photos of that.
Of course, that's your former life. It's called being a kid and then growing into an adult.
So, anyways,
everyone will see Rub's little chubby. Okay, well,
yeah, I know. I was a fatty. I was a fatty growing up. I was a fatty going into my 20s.
You were a cute little fatty.
Uh huh. Well, at least I'm no longer fatty. That's all that counts for the most part. I got a little bit of gut still loose, but I'm gonna be getting there.
Anywho, what's your voting story?
My voting story is just the kind of talk about like the indoctrination you have growing up as a kid. So I was I had to be in the sixth grade, maybe I'm thinking sixth grade. It was 96.
You were in the sixth grade.
98, I graduated grade school.
In 96, you were in sixth grade.
Yeah, Clinton was running for re-election against Bob Dole.
How old were you in 96?
Oh, sixth grade? I don't know.
How old was I in 96?
I don't even want to know. But see, this is the problem. Like, when you go back so far, when you date someone that's 10 years younger than you, you have these things. Don't ever play the 9/11 game. Where were you on 9/11? Like, no. I was in high school on 9/11.
I was born in 93. I was, like, in second grade.
On 9/11?
Yeah, I remember.
Second grade.
Yeah, I remember because our history teacher was like, oh, the United States is so badass. Like, no one will ever fuck with us. Like, we got armies. They're overseas, like, making sure everyone's straight.
I was 17. You were 7.
And our history teacher was telling us about how gangster the United States was. And then a plane flew through a building. And then everyone was just, like, freaking out. And they had us, like, under our desk. It was weird.
They had you under your desk?
They were like, oh, they're going to take out of school next.
Did people in Georgia thought, like, that the terrorists were going to, like, you know, fly a plane into your school down in Georgia?
I don't know. I don't think so. I think they were just, like, paranoid.
I remember listening to Q101 going into school. And I was listening to Mancow, and Mancow was like freaking out about how they're worried about a plane flying into the John Hancock building or the Sears Tower in Chicago. I remember people freaking out about that.
They were freaking out about it, and then...
Yeah, they thought Chicago was next, but...
Everyone thought they were next.
Yeah, but Chicago's a major city, so it would make...
Well,
it has the tallest buildings.
Maybe they were looking for a low spot. I don't know. Everyone was just freaking out. But so you were telling people to vote on your field trip?
No, yeah. So like back in the sixth grade, I had this, social studies class or something like that. Who knows? Indoctrination camp, what it be. And
are we going to send our children to school?
No, we're not going to send our kids to school. Why the hell would we do that shit? Like, why would we put kids through a torture of going through... public school.
Luckily, we wouldn't have to. Like, the Praxium offers classes, and there's so many other means.
Oh, there's such a great homeschooling network in New Hampshire, especially with all the porks that are doing unschooling and all homeschooling. I don't know if I'm 100% on board with unschooling. I need more convincing on that. Homeschooling to a degree.
Like, really? I feel like unschooling would be great.
So just let her, just let your kid do whatever he wants. No, just let him, like, no. Don't teach him anything. Let him learn on the go.
No. Because Tilo was unschooled, and it's basically that you let them pick an area where they want to focus. Like, it's not just learning on the go. Like, it's giving them things to learn, and if, you know, they stick with it or they keep going. Like, I've seen a lot of examples, even at Prime Manor, when I was, like, working in their daycare center, like, they were just letting the kids do whatever they wanted. And they had circuit boards. They had a lot of, like, activities and stuff for them to work on. It just wasn't like, okay, we're going to learn math at 2. We're going to learn reading at 3. It's more of, like, letting them specialize in something.
Yeah, an unstructured, like, teaching environment. Learning environment. I get that. You just I'm not against that.
It's just taking out the structure of it and letting your kid explore. But that's the thing. You have to have, like, you have to be fully invested. Like, you have to have, like, activities and things. Like, give them the opportunity to explore new things. I don't know. I feel like it could be interesting, an interesting concept, especially because I know Tilo was...
She's a success story, for sure.
Yeah, she was taught that way, and that's why she focused on dance more. Like, her parents weren't like, oh, no, like, it's time for, like, math right now. Like, no, if you want to dance, like, let's, like, perfect that, you know, skill. I feel like that would be awesome. I feel like, just like you, like, school, public school was like a torture chamber. And it was like, they were trying to harness my mind into, like, one direction. And it was like my mind was everywhere and I wanted to explore and be creative. And it was like I was always advanced, like, especially in reading, because I've loved reading since forever. So, I don't know. School wasn't great for me. I feel like I taught myself.
Well, school sucks, kids. If you can drop out, homeschool yourself or unschool yourself, Martin would come back.
We'll talk about the pledge.
Oh. Oh, I know what I want to play during the break.
Babe, I thought you were going to take the videos and put them on the side of us, like, put them in front of us instead of putting them in the background.
To be perfectly honest, I played that for like 30 seconds and that was it.
Okay, but are you going to do it with the other one?
With the Vermin Supreme one?
Yeah, I feel like that just looks better if you do it on the side, like how you did the Kylo Ren video.
Yeah, I get that.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should come by the forum.
I'm going to play this video. Of if Donald Trump was a good president. Oh wait, hold on. I don't have the audio. God damn it. Damn it. This is hilarious. Just watch, kids. Just watch.
Say what you will about Mr. Trump, he certainly would bring some change to the White House.
I believe that you will shape our future, and given the ties between our countries.
When Mexico sends its people, they are sending their best. They're bringing jobs.
This is so epic.
They're bringing a sign of strength, right?
I love Mexican people. There is a sense
he loves everybody.
Spirit. The people I'm talking about are nice people.
They want somebody strong, decisive, and it's a deep emotional attachment you have.
They're sending us the best and the finest.
I love Ukraine. I love the Chinese people. I love the Tea Party.
I love Japan. Wounded soldiers who I love.
College debt. It's out of control. And students are borrowing money, and a lot of them can't get jobs.
Walls don't work. I want people.
Walls don't work.
The American dream is bigger and better and stronger than ever before. Thank you. If I am president, you're going to be so proud of our country. You will be the happiest people.
This is really great. That's really great. This is the same guy from What If Joffrey Was a Hero?
Yeah.
Share that video in the chat.
I can just play it. I got time. If I could share it, let me see. Let me find it.
No, I meant you should share this, the If Donald Trump Was a Good President in the chat.
I don't want to play that again. All right, here we go. All right, chat.
Enjoy.
Here you go. But what if Joffrey was a good king?
What if,
you know?
It was the next video. Like, down. From where you were. What if Joffrey was a hero?
Should I play it?
Yeah.
Man, I might just chill tonight.
Puppy monkey baby. Puppy monkey baby.
Ugh. Don't care.
And winter is coming. You won't be a boy forever.
Game of Thrones spoilers for anyone watching.
Sun's finally shining. Come walk with me. Don't like to see you upset.
Is there anything I ever wanted?
Hit you again.
No.
I should have spent more time with you. I was never meant to be a father.
Someday, you'll sit on the throne and the truth will be what you make it.
Before me, it was father.
My father is not the king.
Joffrey Baratheon is the one true heir to the Iron Throne.
All hail his grace, Joffrey of Houses Baratheon and Lannister, first of his name.
My mother tells me a king should never strike his lady. You are my lady, and I will love you from this day until my last day.
There sits the only king I mean to bend my knee to.
He'll be the greatest king that ever was, a golden lion, and I'll give him something.
Yeah, she deserved everything that she got to her. Like, I couldn't stand her. She definitely wasn't a fucking Stark.
She was young. She was young.
So is what's her name? Arya.
They both
she pulled the ball. She did good.
Yeah, but she didn't have any teenage hormones. Now she's just murderous.
We need to attack them.
Joffrey stopped them. You led the defense of King's Landing. They adore you. Marjorie has her claws in Joffrey. She knows how to manipulate him.
Look at her fat. Look at her fat. I didn't even notice that in the show either.
I think they played that out of order.
Doesn't well, obviously, that doesn't matter.
Joffrey was the hero.
What if Joffrey is the good guy? As the hero of Westeros.
Fuck Joffrey.
All right, we're coming back soon.
November 26. That was great. Test subjects no longer believed that food had ever existed. An unshakable
belief subject had to eat all of the food on the planet in order to prevent food from. I'll finish my I'll bring it back with my story of being indoctrinated as a kid. Negotiated with diplomatic with the lab report. I'm Aisha Patel. And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, and we are live right now on LRN.FM. We're also live on IPMNation, and go to rebelloveshow.com/live, so not only can you watch our studio cam and see the Rebel Mistress here bouncing around with their bumpers, but you can also chat on there as well, and don't forget, we do take Skype calls, Skype username, Rebel Love Show.
Guys, Skype us. We want to talk to you about politics and shit. Rebel Love Show, Skype us.
So
bring it on, all your weird questions.
When I was in my indoctrination camp back as a kid in the sixth grade, when you were very young.
I was like three, right?
Yeah, I don't even want to think about it that way. It was like a social studies class, and I remember like having to make political signs, but instead of them being like for like Bob Dole or Bill Clinton, which we had a mock election in class. I believe Bill Clinton won by a landslide. We had to go on this field trip for like the whole fucking day. Like the whole damn day. It was like, no, it was like over half the day. It was like from lunch all the way to the end of the day. And we like, it was like a voting parade. And we walked around like the entire neighborhood. Like literally like walking down the streets in an entire neighborhood holding signs saying, go vote today, like stuff like that, like all these kids.
Aww,
so
cute little sixth graders.
No, that's not cute. Telling like it's us being vote. Enslaved by the system
and
forcing
child
us,
labor too.
And child labor,
free child labor.
For the go tell the people that are under, you know, that kingdoms, that fiefdom under that warlord's control, to go forth and tell other people to vote for their who they want to be their master.
Pretty fucked up, yeah.
Yeah.
No wonder you were such a statist growing up.
Hey, it was a hardcore indoctrination. Like, I wasn't, you know.
Yeah, I remember just feeling like the pledge was wrong. Like, I always felt like I was a child who, you know, moved around a lot. So I questioned the legitimacy of everything, especially school, because it was like you had to ask permission to piss, like you had to ask permission
walk so
down the hall, like get a soda. Yeah. Like no wonder we're breeding such fucking sheeple and who want to vote for a supreme leader. They want someone to like direct their lives because that's what they're used to. That's
oh
what school's
God.
Teaching.
I remember growing up that like it was so indoctrinating for like how like government is. So basically, they had these things called demerits. In my grade school, where they would issue you a demerit. If you got 3 demerits, you got detention. So it'd be like being late one day, or maybe like acting up in class or whatever. It didn't really matter. But if you got 3, you got detention. But it's like paperwork. It's like if you didn't get that permit,
yeah,
you know, like if you didn't go fill out this form. Yeah, stuff like that. They would like issue like they even had like a receipt for it and stuff. It was like horrible. And I'm
yeah.
like,
what the, we, you know, we had then, like a dot system. I remember
a dot system.
Like if you got like a red dot, you had to like take it to your parents and get it signed. And if you had 3 warnings, you know, first they didn't tell the parents, and you just had to sit out at recess. And then if you were like sitting out at recess and you did something extra bad, you got a red dot, and your parent had to sign off on you being a person. I don't know. It was stupid. And I remember I didn't take my red dot home.
Well, you were a rebel when you were a kid.
I was like, I'm not.
I didn't become a rebel until after, during high school.
I was like, I'm not going to take this red dot home. Fuck that shit. Like, I'm not going to be defined by this red dot. Like, I'll sit out as many recesses as you want. Because that was the deal. Like, you had to get it signed to go back to the recess or something. I was like, fuck recess.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Like, who cared about recess? Like, oh, I get to stand. It's like being in a jail. Like, here's this time for you to be outside for a little bit.
Yeah, here's your prison guard time.
Like, look at like a prison movie or a TV show, and you're like, man, that's exactly like school, but the only difference is there's, you know, instead of like, you know, correctional people, which are now at schools, if we count all the cops nowadays at schools.
Yeah, there are so many cops.
Yeah, like it's like a fortress. It's like this huge, you know,
metal detectors everywhere.
Well, that's like more to keep people in.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's just like how
I remember in elementary school, there was this guy who tried to run away, and the police were like chasing him across the playground because he was trying to run away from school.
Really?
Yeah.
Like the cops chased him down because he's running away from his government training facility, indoctrination camp.
Yes, you were not allowed to just leave. Like, he got up and he was like, I'm leaving.
Isn't this crazy that we have this world where kids are forced to be put into a building for against their will?
8 hours a day.
You know, with other adults and kids that they may not even want
to
see.
Like, forced to be in a room with them and, like, inhale and somehow socially air and acceptable ask them for permission for to piss. You get 5 minutes of hall time. You have to walk in a straight line. Like, I don't know. It's giving me anxiety just thinking
about it. It's intense that, like, that is the state of the affairs of, like, that's considered normal. And most people want their kids to go to that. Most people want their kids to, like, go to school.
I know you watched Weeds. So the episode Weeds, when they were on the road and Shane finally asked if he, you know, had to go back to school. And she was like, nah, you know, high school is an awkward time. It's an awkward place, like a bunch of teenagers being bitchy and hormonal, like infused, like just adolescents everywhere. It's just not a great, you know, like who cares if you skip it?
Well,
like,
he's getting a lot more street smart.
Definitely. But I feel like that's the way life works, even if you're not like some big time, you know, drug mom fleeing, you know, whatever. Like, high school is an awkward place. Like, most of school is an awkward place. And I do remember, like, that kid running and them trying to catch him. And I always thought, like, I didn't know, like, I didn't have the option not to leave. Like, that was my first time realizing, you know, kind of that I was stuck there. Like, even if I wanted to leave, I couldn't. And there is something fucked up about that.
See, I never really realized that until after I was out of school. To be perfectly honest, I know. I was deep in the Matrix, man. I was deep in the Matrix. I jacked myself out, but like I thought it wasn't like you're supposed to go to school, but like that was like how society worked. Like you went to school, like this just seemed like the thing you're supposed to do.
Just like voting is what you're supposed.
Yeah, exactly. You know, like the best slaves are the ones that don't know they're a slave. Like if they actually don't even know that they are.
But I feel like that goes back to just like. People just bring this election is bringing out like the hatred in the world, because I feel like it goes back to school, like these government schools pushing out these sheeple who are now I read this actually a great article just questioning the morality of people who are voting for Trump and like why. And a lot of it was because they believe the world is, like, headed to chaos and they're sheeple and they want someone to fix it for them. And they feel like a supreme leader will do that. And that's why they want to vote for Trump. And I felt like that is just, like, sad and, like, sickening. Like, this world is just so, like, fearful and, like, evil that they want to vote for someone like this. So I wanted to do my research and just, I like I said, before we went on break a while ago, I kind of felt like this whole wall thing, like, I don't know. I thought he would, like, phrase it better or something. I don't know what I expected.
He's upfront about it. You know, he's upfront about what he literally wants to charge the Mexicans to build a wall. I mean, but let's be honest here. That wall's not for the Mexicans. That's for us. That's to keep people in. That's not to keep people out.
Do you really think that?
Yes.
Why?
I really do think. Why? Because, I mean, he's not going to say this as a campaign.
A nation without borders is not a nation.
Well, good.
Donald Trump quote.
I would agree with you in that. A nation does have to have borders.
Really? You believe in borders?
No, I believe a nation needs to have borders. I do not believe in the fact for nations to have borders. I am very no I'm a very no borders person. I don't think there should be any borders, but I'm just saying if there is a nation, like a nation needs borders.
So if you go to donaldjtrump.com/positions immigration reform, you'll find his wall segment. And we'll talk about it a little bit more when we come back.
Oh, that was a beautiful, that was beautiful, Baby Doll. Brought to you by the same guys that did Seals and Clubs. They're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. You know, I think we should do some, ASMR porn.
Why?
Just like whenever, just wearing the headphones, like hearing us, like do things. Unbelievable.
It's my turn to bring it back, right?
Yeah, what do you want to bring it back with?
We're going to talk about the wall.
This wall? The wall, the build all walls. What is this? What is this?
Pony orgies? Oh, Derek J is on. Is that really Derek J?
Hey, chat?
Boo. How you doing?
Oh, hey, it's Derek J.
Oh, hey. Victimlesscrimespree.com. Instead of just listening, you can also watch. See the Liberty Radio Network's key New Hampshire-based live shows via our studio cam at cam.lrn.fm.
You also missed the Rebel Mistress bouncing her tits around.
I wasn't bouncing.
I don't know what you're doing. You're distracting the hell out of me. Jesus Christ.
It's like cold in here, and like one nipple gets really hard because I have like a piercing there.
Right there.
And it just makes them like unbelievably hard. But anyway. This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for under...
Yeah, no, Riker's done a lot better. I agree. Right.
That's 5,000 square feet. Don't say his name, he gets distracted. Manufacturers, if
you need a larger building, that's true.
Just say dog. I don't think he knows.
Try just leaning back. Lean back for a second, babe.
It's either.
No, it doesn't do much.
Yeah. I'm gonna sit right here. This is a good angle.
Okay. Yeah. That's a great angle. Show off the goods. We're trying to get hits on YouTube, babe. Show some cleavage. That's all I'm trying to say. Don't hide the babies. Hide the puppies.
LRN.FM are 1. Let your friends know you're listening to LRN.FM on your social networking profile. 2. Buy the things you buy online through shop.LRN.FM. 3. Give $5 a month to the AMP program at amp.LRN.FM. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same great prices, and LRN gets a cut. Please do your online shopping at shop.LRN.FM.
Cryptocurrency and peer-to-peer tech developments happen fast. Stay in the loop with the Daily Decrypt, a new video channel and podcast that will keep you on top of the latest innovations.
Oh, you already posted in Seas of Liberty? Security,
networking, transportation, and gadgets.
No,
you posted something else, sorry.
Daily Decrypt on YouTube and SoundCloud, and be an early adopter of the future. The Daily Decrypt.
Do you love Twitter?
Jesus, babe, mute the mic before you cough.
I'm sorry. My apologies.
You almost just took out my ear. And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. You know, sometimes I have problems. And I feel like we all have problems in life. And the only way to fix those problems is obviously to build a giant wall between your giant problems. Wall.
I'm down for a struggle.
Okay.
Let's keep all those brown people immigrants out of our land.
So if you go to DonaldJTrump.com and you look into immigration reform, he says that there should be a wall across the southern border.
They bring crime. They bring diseases. Can't have them on our properties.
And he also uses this wording, make Mexico pay for the wall. Not, you know, ask nicely. Not, you know, negotiate, talk about it. Let's see. Maybe we can go half and half. No, make. Make Mexico.
Might makes right.
Pay for this wall. This giant wall. And why? And why? Why should you do that? You know, I took debate in college. I'm really good at debate. Like, I was great at it. This is why we argue all the time. But I can't, you know, I can't debate with Rob.
Wouldn't you want reparations if someone was damaging your property, our house? And we had to build something to prevent that from happening? You know what? I would be like, hey, give us some money for this. We're trying to help you out, too. That's what Trump's doing. That's all he's doing. That's the reason why that he wants that, you know, the Mex, it's only fair for them to pay. It's for them because look, he just wants to keep all the Americans in. Okay. This is gonna help Mexico in the future. This is a win-win.
Okay, so I'm glad that you said that. Like, if that was Trump's defense, okay, maybe I could start, you know, going into that positioning. But his defense for this wall and why Mexico should pay is because last week, an illegal immigrant who has an arrest record beat a 64-year-old woman. He crushed her skull and eye sockets with a hammer, raping her and murdering her.
Oh my God. That sounds like the police hell chief, has broken upon the police, American people from the South.
The police
war
chief,
has been declared.
The police chief in Santa Maria says the blood trail leads straight to Washington. So you might think I'm reading a satire article. You might think like I am reading something other than the official website for the political candidate for president, Donald Trump. But nope, this is his policy. If you go there, these are his policies, and this is why he thinks that we should build a giant wall. Not we, because let me just ask you, at what point do we leave when the wall starts going up?
When do we leave? That's a good question.
Because once this wall starts being built,
if there's hope enough for New Hampshire to declare independence, you know, we got a good chance just to ride it out here. Right?
I don't want to be here.
What if New Hampshire, I will volunteer to go to Mars. What if we get New Hampshire to secede from the Union before Trump is able to build the wall? What if New Hampshire is its own independent nation prior to that happening?
Okay.
Then do we still leave?
No. Then it's not our problem. We just make sure we have enough arms to like make sure he's not.
But what if the next president then becomes some sort of like you know,
then the presidency like the Putin has nothing
of North
to do
America
with
that's like the Ukraine is ours. We're gonna go back and take it. You know, no, what if like some like
he,
future
this supreme leader, he wants to build a wall to Mexico. He said this is a guy who said waterboarding wouldn't be the worst form of torture that he would give to somebody. He would bring out a hell of a lot more than that. So if you think that he's gonna let New Hampshire peacefully secede, you're like in la-la,
you know,
fucking land.
One thing I never understood with a lot of liberals was with torture. Like, they go apeshit over, like, waterboarding and stuff like that. But you never hear, well, maybe it's because it's Obama now, but, like, they never really talk much about drones. Like, they never really do to the point like that we do. Like, you know, we literally have these robots in the sky that can go anywhere and drop, you know, hellfire missiles with GPS, like, accuracy. everywhere, anywhere on the planet. Like,
yeah,
you know, we have like these people that their sole job is to literally sit at a computer desk, very like the one I'm sitting at, and hold a controller
and drop
just
bombs
kill
on
people yeah. all day long as if it's a video game. Like, that's like the world that like the U.S. military, or I believe that's pretty much all the Air Force, you know, is becoming, is just like drone pilots.
Yeah.
Which is this insanity that that's something that even takes place in this world that we live in.
And but they'll definitely do that to you if you try to secede. So, still, you haven't answered my question.
Oh, what,
because
what was your
once
question?
There's a giant wall, like, being put into place, and New Hampshire hasn't seceded, and New Hampshire tries to secede, and I feel like it's, like, District fucking 8 or 13, because we're going back to the Hunger Games here, how the Hunger Games starts, and then they just bomb the shit out of New Hampshire, and, like, this is your example. I don't know. But people want that. People are voting for hate. People are voting for giant walls, missiles, torture, racism, sexism, like bigotry.
You're down for...
People are voting for that.
So you'll say you'll hold it down here, but the point of no return is once the wall of the end all walls is being built. That's the time
once,
when you're like, fuck the United States... living in this country, you'll jump ship.
First of all, once...
You go expat.
Yeah. I'm moving overseas. I'm going to Uruguay. We need to get our passports ready. Because he came in second in the primaries. And I'm just saying. Like, honestly. Like, let's go back in history to walls being built. And what happens, like, after that. Even if it's years after that. Like, it's just a... He's just installing fear. That's his, like, goal.
Yeah, no,
and it's
Trump
working.
Yeah, it's sad to see that we're, you know, we like to think that as a people, as a culture, I have to say we. I hate saying we too.
I
don't
want to
use it,
here.
But we're still, you know, as much as we say we're libertarians or anarchists or, you know, porcupines, what a free staters. We're people. We're human beings, and we all live on this continent. We're all living in what people like to call the United States of America. You know, we're living in this geographical landmass, and you know, it feels like sometimes societal wise, we're on like a whole nother wavelength. We're like live and let live. You know, like we're all human beings. Like, let's just get along. Like, what's the big deal? How is this even an issue? And then you have someone that, like, as Trump is using populism and getting hugely, you know, all his backing
there
from, like, all these racist people.
There are some who support Trump.
Well, there's a couple of porks. I know of, God, what's his name?
It doesn't matter his
name. Yeah, yeah, yeah. He ran for state senate here.
He actually
But he's
said
a local.
The,
I don't think he's a...
He was in the press conference, and he was like, yeah, that's me.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, how can you call yourself a free stater and believe that you should build walls?
Oh my God, that's not free staters. Like, get that guy, run him out of town. Like, I don't know how you can't be calling yourself that. He has no idea what he's talking about.
More when we come back.
Yeah, but I'm also really high, babe.
Okay, well, I'm not. Is an independent alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to... Have you ever been checking Skype?
Freedom, what?
Have you ever been checking Skype?
Yeah, I have. Okay. No one's calling today.
Call in, everyone. Talk to us about stuff.
Ooh, for Uruguay. Derek.
Yeah, we need to move to Uruguay. But seriously, because you still didn't answer it. At what point would you want to leave? It doesn't have to be because of the wall.
I don't know. I would want to leave, though.
I'm just saying.
I'm not against.
I need to leave or try to secede immediately. From wrestling superstars
like Glenn Jacobs. You guys really are. I agree. Impact, I believe. Like I said,
A lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live and changed my mind on some very important
issues. I saw that earlier. To random people tuning in on the
radio. I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on Saturday night. From there, I went on doing the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting free talk.
Am I bringing it back?
People looking for talk radio.
What am I coming back to? What do you want to talk about? I want to talk about.
We haven't talked about anything yet. And amp podcast. We are still. Let's talk about anything on this list. This is your Roberts Brookridge Daily Precious
Metals Update. Oh, I want to go to my Oregon rank because there's only two segments left.
Okay.
Can I jump to that?
Silver's up
4 cents, okay. $15.39.
Well, we were talking about the pledge, and you were supposed to jump to it, but you didn't. US dollars.
We're offering up to 200 gold. Oh, yeah, that would have been a good segue. Damn it. Ounce price
each. I can't help you with everything. Special at 800-874-9760
or visit us online at rrbi.co.
Did you know why you get news updates about
what's happening with the Liberty Radio Network delivered in the way you
Some
prefer?
Some of us, they want to call in and suck on my titties. Plus, you
can
stay
in the loop by joining our Facebook. I can't blame them, baby.
I don't know how they would do that through a call in.
Technology's going to let us do a lot in the future.
For news updates delivered to your email box, facebook.lrn.fm to follow our Facebook page, and twitter.lrn.fm to receive our tweets.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it.
I'm excited that Murdoch is coming to Porkfest.
Yeah. So is he ex-nate?
Do you want to? Do you want to? No. Yeah, no. Well, he's not part of the party. But do you want to camp with him? Do you want to incorporate him into our campsite with Daniel? Do this
right now. Don't sure, but I feel like. With I
know this sounds unbelievable. Don't do that.
It should be like our wedding party. Off of a new item
on Amazon. This information I got you.
But maybe. You do things. Go to
saveitpurse.com. We need to figure that stuff out.
Yeah, we should start a group chat right now.
Yeah, I know. We should.
Me, 15 to 25% off of everyone in the wedding party.
Yeah.
Silver element.
Yeah.
LRN.FM
exactly.
Anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Go check out rebelloveshow.com/live. You can be watching us live and chatting on the LRN chat on that website. So I have a rant, and I hate ranting like this, but, you know, I need to talk about it. So we really haven't talked much at all about the whole rancher situation that happened that went down in Oregon. But I've been following it, and when they killed, Robert Lavoy Finicum, who was kind of like the spokesperson for the militia there in Oregon, they're en route to a town hall meeting in that county, and they got chased off the road by the feds, and he went out with his hands up saying, don't shoot, like he's literally has his hands up, and they released the drone footage of them executing him, just filling him up with bullets. On Facebook, I have like all these crazy connections with like all these different people in the liberty movement and whatnot, it was released a video, like someone who's like been following this on the ground releasing video. Her name is Roxana Hall, and she shared this video of the memorial service for Finicum, and it's a bunch of people waving American flags, okay, waving American flags, and saying the Pledge of Allegiance. All right. That is what was shared, and it is intense seeing like all these people You know, they literally
like,
just...
Did they not get it?
I don't know. Like, they just killed your one of your leaders in cold blood. Murdered him. All right? And you're, and for your his memorial service, you're going to pledge allegiance to the murderers, wave the murderer's flag over, like, his, like, death site? Like, that's their response. This is, like, a heart-to-heart to, like, any conservative that actually like, will listen to this or something like that. Like, what do they have to do? What do they have to do for you not want to be an American anymore?
Exactly.
Like, to that's say, like, I'm still a proud American. I'm still going to pledge allegiance to the American empire.
I literally just asked you that. Like, what do they have to do? Like, you know? Like, well, for me, it's like
getting the hell out of the country. And another thing to say, like, I don't want to associate with the people that call themselves the government or, like, consider myself an American or anything like that.
Yeah. I feel like on a global scale, like, people, I don't know, like, something devastating, something tragic. Because you see how deep the indoctrination goes. Like, they don't even realize, like, the irony of them, like, sitting there waving American flags. They don't get that.
I mean,
like...
These are armed people that came to, like, you know, they could have been, now, they could have, the feds could have done worse. They could have pulled another Waco and just slaughtered everyone there. Like, that could have been a possibility. And that wouldn't be out of the realm, like, of what the feds normally do.
It doesn't matter how many people they kill. Like, one person is too many.
It just saddens me. It's like, you're willing to take up arms for this issue of yours, but you still worship the same, like, organization you're fighting. Like, that doesn't make any sense.
That's like, why
you're willing to die for this cause and yet still worship the people that you're fighting to death for. Like, that doesn't make any sense. Like, how can this be? It makes me lose hope that, like, you know, much of the country wouldn't support secession because, like, here's these militia people, you know.
Much of the country is still very indoctrinated. I feel like people are evolving and people are changing more and more, like, each day. But there's still, like, a large percentage of the country who are just sheeple who just want, like, to be told what to do, who want to be owned. Like, they want to be slaves. And that's bad, you know. But... they don't even realize, like, their own chains, or they don't even care. They all have Stockholm at this point.
You can't even tell them that, you know. And you can't go up to them and be like, you know. I've tried to do this. I really tried to avoid it, like, with most people. I don't want to be that person that, like, is so controversial, like, in the room. Like,
yeah, you know, me either. I don't like it.
I don't want
to. But you know, and you also can't tell someone else what to believe. I feel like people have to find it for themselves. Like, I feel like I can help them. I can, like, say something where I'm like, oh, like, for instance, I had, like, written down here the issue about, like, abortions and stuff like that. Like, people can talk about, oh, like, oh, this person's pro this, pro that. And, like, my stance is always, like, I you know, I don't really care who's pro what, you know. My uterus, anything inside of my own body, like, should be up to me. And, like, my guy, OBGYN, like, and whoever else I choose to lend to my body sexually. So, you know, when they try to get into the politics, I just kind of take it back to, you know, for me. You know, and I, that way I feel like I'm not being as controversial, you know, because I don't say, yeah, I'm pro-abortion. Like, I don't say that necessarily. I just say whatever I decide to, you know. I mean, I feel like that's the difference, how you can avoid it. But I feel like that also gets people to think a little bit more about who owns you. It's all the question. It all comes back to that.
Oh,
who
yeah.
owns you? Like, once you ask yourself, like, that question, like, are you going to put, like, like, you know, the Snapchat box? Who are you voting for? They say, who owns you? Bernie Sanders?
Oh, my God.
Donald Trump? Like,
I've also loved the memes of, like, Bernie Sanders supporters getting, like, furious when someone steals a Bernie Sanders bumper sticker.
Yeah. What? It's free.
I'm like, but you do realize that's how he's going to pay for everything, right? He's going to steal from other people, a.k.a. it's called taxes. And pay for that, and that's how economic illiterate that Sanders people are, that they don't even understand the irony of them posting pictures about, like, someone stealing their stickers.
Oh, I've seen those memes.
You know, that's true, though. That's absolutely true. That's how Bernie Sanders supporters
are. Everyone's like, it's like the less of two evils. I actually really feel like Bernie Sanders, like, might take it, and if he doesn't, I feel like then Trump would be next. And if Trump wins, I feel like he deserves the win, because... like, that just says something about the vast population. And it'll probably help with New Hampshire secession.
If Trump wins?
Maybe.
Yeah.
Since
yeah.
Trump won in New Hampshire, I don't know.
Yeah, that's crazy. I mean,
maybe people in New Hampshire want to build their own wall, so they like that Trump is pro walls.
No, I don't get the Trump support. I really don't.
What didn't you tell me? It's big business. The guy who's been like bankrupt 3 times. Like,
yeah, but he's big business. He knows how to be a business person because he says so. He's like he sold the country on him. He had a reality TV show about it. I mean, that's how he got fired.
He got
fired from his own show?
Yes, he got fired from his own show. The You're Fired show, he got fired from.
For what?
Something, money, I don't know.
Oh, whatever,
look it up.
Don't matter.
He got fired from his own show. He's went bankrupt many times. But it's all about being a supreme leader. And we watched a video, actually, about him playing mind games or like manipulating people.
He definitely is a master politician because he'll paint people into a corner where no matter how they respond, he still wins.
Yeah,
like he still won the conversation. He's almost like when he talks to people, he's attacking them, but he's mentally like doing like chess gymnastics attacking them, where like he tries to paint them to where they don't have the ability to like respond properly.
I went around the internet and I looked for pro Trump videos because I really wanted to see like them like point out exactly the reasons what they like about him so and so. And you know, I didn't really find any videos like that. I found like videos of like them saying things about Trump, but not him actually saying anything. And I found that weird because, like, you know, everything that comes out of his mouth is a steaming pile of bullshit.
Yeah.
So it's like, in every other, like, candidate is basically the same way. But him, I found no videos of him actually speaking.
One thing cool with Trump, if you were cool with Trump, one thing that people probably like about him is he does seem like he's an outside candidate. He's like he's not an establishment person. That's probably why people like him. I don't know.
They probably
I can't
like him
stand
for gun rights.
People just want the...
Don't people want
a
monarchy?
No.
Vote for Hillary. This pimple on my face. I have a huge pimple on my face.
I know, you should just pop it.
I think it just popped itself.
Let me see.
No!
You're fine.
I'm bringing it back. Right. I'm gonna bring it back with elections don't matter. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine. So you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Is this our last segment, actually? Credit Success Secrets Revealed. After this?
Yeah.
Okay, so we need to talk about our spirit journey.
Yeah.
What? Are we giving off the stereotype of polysex being druggies?
Oh, there's a post in the Porcupines group.
Really?
Yeah.
Where?
It wasn't about us.
What
but that Jay Curious guy posted it. There's like actually a pretty long thread about it.
Too concerned regarding the characters and folks and images I keep hearing about heavy drug use, Polly and Ronnie. Turning on the radio and hearing the Liberty Radio Network. You can make that vision a reality with your own micro radio station. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how you can put our programs on the air in your area. You can have lrn.fm running around the clock, and you can even add in your own local shows. Building a radio station is simple, but programming isn't. That's where lrn.fm comes in. Learn more at broadcast.lrn.fm. That's broadcast.lrn.fm.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards managing and improving it. This is Charlie.
I don't think we do enough drugs, so.
Well, how many more drugs do you want to do? Your payment
history. No, I like the amount of drugs we do, but we don't do them that often.
compared to the regular person, we do a lot of drugs.
When we do a lot of drugs, we do a lot of drugs. But when we don't
do them that often.
Yeah,
yeah, no.
We don't. We party,
but we don't party that hard that often.
Yeah.
I agree.
We have jobs, people. We publish books and go to Verizon. Sorry. Didn't mean to call you out there, babe.
People figure it out.
Well, you can edit that part out of the commercial. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting Van Dyke Mortgage. And say it on air.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
The three most important things you can do for LRN.FM are: 1. Let your friends know you're
Jesus, this is a long thread.
Right?
Profile. 2. Buy the things you buy online through shop.lrn.fm.
I made a comment saying something along the lines of, like, I'm probably not helping the stereotype.
That's kind of like, this guy posted in there that he wanted to move, but he doesn't like the homosexual agenda. And he doesn't want to be forced to, like, you know,
well,
with the homophobia.
Then don't fucking move. That's post.
Did you see it?
No, I didn't even see that.
It was in there, yeah. It was in there. He was talking, I don't want to move, but I don't want to be pushed. I don't want the homophobic agenda pushed on me. I'm a Christian. Are there any Christians like me? It might have been this guy. I want to find the exact post.
All right, we're coming back in a second. Shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's
amp.lrn.fm. And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. We're talking about politics and shit. So I did want to point out something about the monarchy concept. I thought more people would probably be down for it because I hear people say, like, you know, a lot of libertarians even, that we should have never left the monarchy. Maybe we'd be in a different situation right now.
You think things would be better if the American Revolution never happened?
No.
What do you say?
I'm just saying people say that. Anyway, so I thought, like, the whole Hillary Bush would take, like, stronger precedent here. Like,
you know, I'm really rooting for Bush because I want a Bush versus Clinton race.
Yeah.
And this supposed to bring back the good old days.
Bush and Clinton, like, represents what, like, the true monarchy that America
is. I mean, so many people, I mean, let's, I actually really want that to happen. I want Bernie supporters to go, like, all the way to, like, the convention and still not get the nomination and just disenfranchise all these Bernie Sanders supporters and allow a Clinton Bush race to just, like, make it seem like
that's not going to happen. And you want to know why? So an FSPer actually got to ask Hillary Clinton on CNN, and they asked her about marijuana legalization. And, you know, she said she'd think about it. She definitely wants to, like, see research.
Now, she'd throw people in jail.
But she is concerned about the overdose issue. Bitch, please. Like, the only thing marijuana is an overdose to is Cheetos. Like, I don't remember the last time I OD'd on marijuana. Yeah,
I OD'd on some cupcakes that
I had left over from the bridal shower, maybe. But I've never OD'd on marijuana. And so, like, the fact that that's her answer to questions, and she really never has any answers. Like,
Most politicians don't.
Yeah, she'll just sway, like, whatever sounds good. Like, yeah, I'll work on it, except for how I want it all. I won't at all, and I have no knowledge on marijuana whatsoever because I just said it has something to do with the overdose problem. Like, like, she literally just spouting shit from her
ass. She also said she'd go down to a Schedule 2, which is, like, bullshit, because that's still a felony.
People don't like her. The only reason someone would vote for her is because her name is Clinton.
Yeah, and she'd be the first woman president.
All the feminists will vote. All the liberal feminists.
No, fuck that shit.
No,
because you cannot vote for someone just because they're a woman. And if you are going to vote for someone just because she's a woman, it's going to be a hot woman. It's not going to be some gilf. Like,
look, most women that love Clinton,
she will not win. There's no way in hell. I'm a woman, and I would never vote for her.
Most feminists are sexist. They're pro-Bernie. They hate men. No, they hate men. They will. If there's a female they can vote for, they will vote for a female. Unless it's a conservative female, then fuck that shit. They ain't gonna touch that.
I feel like might as well
be a guy. Actually, it's worse than a guy.
I don't feel like anyone will vote for her. I don't even feel like conservative, like fucking feminists will vote for her. Like, I'm sorry, Hillary. It's not your turn. It'll never be your turn. You couldn't even handle the presidential dick, no less the country. Like, we're done with you. Vote for Monica Lewinsky at that point. But I don't know.
It's fascinating how, like, a war criminal that is being investigated by the FBI right now.
Yeah, she did. Yeah.
Is running for president. Like, that's actually good. You know, if you actually pay attention to politics, yeah, like, that's crazy.
She's just like, oops, I fucked up. Got a whole bunch of people killed. But it's like just like this out in the open conspiracy, but everyone knows about it, and she's still running for president, and everyone's just pretending like that didn't even happen. Hillary now.
Yeah, but there's bullshit. There's so much criminality behind it that no one even cares anymore. Like, the whole family history with the Clintons and everything.
It's just so much criminal activity going on in politics.
But yeah,
I want to see everyone's bank accounts just out in the open. Like, whenever election season starts, maybe you'll make me a statist. Like, maybe you can prove something to me, but I doubt it. Like, there's no morality in politics. Voting is just a waste of time. If Trump wins and he starts building up that wall, me and Rob are moving to Uruguay, and we're calling it a day. That's all I'm saying.
Uruguay?
Yeah.
I don't know, maybe then Costa
we can
Rica,
travel all
please.
Over South America.
We
just
got to
save up, babe. Yeah, save right. Trump.
Well, let's, you
but before
start
we do that.
The bank.
Liberty Forum, which yes. We didn't even mention.
So, if you didn't think Edward Snowden was enough reason to get tickets for Liberty Forum.
Hillary says she would have arrested as a treasonous criminal.
Yeah. The Rebel Love Show is going to be recording live at Liberty Forum, broadcasting live on LRN that Saturday at 2 o'clock.
I feel like Edward Snowden is, like, becoming a bigger reason to come, especially with all this propaganda. Like, on doorstep in America, I'm sure you received it too, there's a picture of Edward Snowden's face with liar, treasonous, all this other shit written all over it. Like,
that's like that doesn't even seem like a
that makes me
like
want to cry. This world is filled with so much hate.
I read that and I was like, man, this is a political ad I can get behind. Yeah, this is the government. He is saying that. That is correct. That's awesome. And then it's like you read the fine print and it's actually
they're talking
it's
about
it's actually
him.
A conservative group that's pissed off at Edward Snowden. And it's just fascinating that I read it as, like, that's awesome.
Of course you did. Of course, like, people want to read it as that. But the point is, like, this kind of propaganda is going to people and they're not thinking that. Like, the average American citizen isn't picking that up and saying, oh, like, yeah, like, that's funny that the government's that. They're thinking, oh, this guy who I've heard about, there's a movie about him. Hillary's talking about how she wants to arrest him. Now we're getting pamphlets saying that he's a treasonous liar. Like, it's all just, like, fear-mongering propaganda. Like, and people are already sheeple. They believe anything they read.
So, yeah, I know. That's how the world is, babe. And what's going on with Flaming Freedom at Liberty Forum?
I don't know. Did you even say? I was taking a drink. Sorry. Did you even say what time Rebel Love Show was recording?
Yes, Rebel Love Show would be on Saturday at 2.
Do we have any guests?
I'm sure we will. Probably Ellen Ball is going to be a guest. Christopher David. Oh, by the way, Christopher David is going to be on next week. He's confirmed, so he'll be talking about Arcade City, which he always does and whatnot. But he hasn't been on since December, so I'm excited about getting him back on.
Nice. And Flaming Freedom will be live at Liberty Forum. I got Stephanie Murphy coming on, Leslie Ann Peterson, hopefully some other people. And that is going to be Friday at 3 o'clock.
Right? Yeah, it's Friday.
Okay,
so.
Nice.
Yeah.
I was just like shooting from nowhere there, people.
you got
Friday
good. You
at
got
3
good.
O'clock. So other I think this weekend we're going to go, or
no, tomorrow.
We're going to go on an epic spirit journey, and we're going to blend in with this green screen. And I don't know, maybe we'll write a blog about it. It's going to be awesome.
I'm excited about it. I want to focus on a lot of things.
Yeah, I want to focus. I want a hippie flip. I wish we had our spiritual shaman, Cody O'Connor. It's nice to have friends that are, if you're like, oh, yeah, I want a trip tonight. Like, they're like, yes, I will guide you. I will be your guidance. I will be your shaman. That's awesome. No, Most people don't have friends like that.
Normally you don't. You know, you need someone there sometimes to play the role of a shaman. He does a great. But we'll be doing it in his honor. But I'm excited. I want to focus on
just make sure that you're super comfortable. You want to focus on you.
Yeah.
You want to have a mind traveling.
Yeah. I want to look into myself and see what, you know, see if there's anything that needs changing, you know, tweaking. Aww. Like, make myself a better person. Like,
what if your spiritual journey says that you should leave me? Are you going to leave me?
No.
Aww.
I can never leave you.
Okay.
No way. That's no way in hell could I leave you, babe.
Like, if Trump starts building this wall, I just want to know that you're down to leave.
Yeah,
you got to declare it on air.
Yeah. Only if New Hampshire isn't about to secede. If it's like on the wire, then I might stay.
I'll be down for a secession.
All right. So let's see.
I'll be on the board. Do you have any activities coming up? Are you guys doing something at Liberty Forum?
Oh, we'll be at Liberty Forum. So me and Ellen, we're going to be at Liberty Forum, man, in the table for the Foundation for New Hampshire Independence. Come check us out. Come say hi. You know, we're talking about what's going on, the whole independence movement going on
here
in New Hampshire.
I'll probably be over there like a groupie.
Like a groupie.
I'll be your groupie. I'll be your foundation groupie.
You're going to be mingling around all over the place.
Probably. Maybe not. I don't know. I'm a bit shy lately. Anywho,
come say hi to the Rebel Mistress.
I'll be cute.
And you got a comedy thing going on.
Yeah, and the comedy show is going to be Thursday night at 7, and that's going to be a lot of fun. I actually wrote one of the scripts there. So first they're going to have improv. If you didn't know, I feel like I didn't tell you that.
Yeah,
like the regular
night.
Improv that you volunteer for. So like that we do at the Quill, uh-huh. We'll do that. And then the comedy sketch will be then. So come visit us and go like Rebel Mistress on Facebook.
And also go check out Flaming Freedom, which she does every Thursday night at 10 p.m. Eastern. Go
Find
check out
RebelLoveShow.com.
Peace, guys.
Peace.